does your squad look for the match against Arsenal? I mean, Courtois, Cahill, Drinkwater, Fabregas, none of those played against Brighton the weekend. Will any of those be available for you?
Morata and Fabregas are out. Yeah, they are not available for Arsenal game. And then I have to check a couple of situations. Awesome. Yeah, but for sure, Morata and Fabregas are out.
And the problem with Morata is?
No. He has a problem in his back and he's injured.
And the others, how concerned are you about Courtois, Cahill, and Drinkwater?
Yeah, and as I said before, and I have to check a couple of situations, yeah, before to make the best decision for tomorrow's game.
And Andreas Christensen, he came off again.
Yeah, he's fit. Okay. Yeah. He trained with us, and he's fit.
This is the third time you've played Arsenal this month. Draw in the league, a draw in the cup. What have you learned from those two matches, and what do you think might be different this time?
Every game is different. Every game is different. I think the game in the league was different than the game in Carabao Cup. I think the game in the league was more open, in one side and the other side. In the first leg in Carabao Cup, I think the game was different. Was different, and in this case, you have two games. You have two games to play before to reach the final. And I think that it's right to have a plan, no? To have a plan. But for sure, the first game for Arsenal was more open when we played at Emirates Stadium.
Do you sense that this second leg will be more open than the first leg?
But for sure there is a target for both teams and to reach the final in this competition. I think this is a good target for us. It's a good target for Arsenal. And for this reason, I think that. After a draw, after a 0-0, for sure the game will be very open.
Henrik Mkhitaryan has joined Arsenal, but can't play against Chelsea. Alexis Sanchez has left Arsenal and gone to Manchester United. Is it a plus for Chelsea that neither Mkhitaryan or Sanchez can play for Arsenal? Is that good news for you?
Are good news, and I think Arsenal has a good squad. And if you remember, in the game at home in the league, Sanchez didn't play. It's the same in Carabao Cup. He played only 10 minutes. He played only against us in the league. And if you remember, we were winning 2-1 for. For minutes to go, yeah. I think that I don't see any advantage about this situation.
What would getting to the final mean for you?
But for me, for my players, for our fans, I think this is an important target, and for us, especially for me, in my first season in 1 year and half. I have the opportunity to play, to win the league and to play the final FA Cup, to play the Community Shield, and then I have the opportunity to play another final in Carabao Cup. I think that in 1 year and a half, I have this possibility to play. Many finals in this country. I think this is very important for me and for my players. But before to reach the final in Carabao Cup, we have to play against Arsenal. And as you know very well, for us, it's always a big challenge. a big game against them. And for sure, Arsenal wants to go to the final in the same way that we want to go.
Tell us what the situation is with Kennedy. Are you expecting that he will go on loan to Newcastle? We understand he's having a medical there.
Yeah, I think he's going. I think he's going on loan to Newcastle. Yeah, I think this.
How important is that for his future development?
Yeah, for sure. We are talking about a young player with great potentiality. In this moment of his career, he needs to play with regularity, and to go to Newcastle this is a great challenge for him, and I think this way is a good way for the club, and we use it the same way for Christensen, and now Christensen is a Chelsea player, and he's always playing in the start 11. And I think this is a good opportunity for him. But at the same time, he must know that he has to fight. He must be ready to fight to play in Newcastle. Because don't forget, last season, and in the first 6 months to Watford, Kennedy struggled a lot to play, and he played only 24 minutes. And but I think now he's more ready. He played with us many games, and I think now he can show his potentiality going on loan.
The fact that the club is letting him go on loan, does that indicate that you have somebody who is coming in? Progress. Yeah. I know you're frustrated sometimes with questions about players in the transfer market, but it's the fans who want to know if someone is coming in.
But as you know very well, before after this question about Kennedy, I said that the club. If decides to go loan one player, then have to decide to buy another player, or then to work with a young player like Sterling from Academy. But as you know very well, I'm ready for both cases, and then the club has to decide the best for the club.
Has there been any progress with Edin Dzeko, Emerson Palmieri?
I don't know. And, as you know very well about the transfer market, if there are news, and the club will inform you.
As far as the other semi-final is concerned, between Bristol City and Manchester City, can Bristol City win? Can they go through? Can they get to Wembley? Will you watch?
The other semi-final, I think that Manchester City in this moment they have a good advantage, because they won 2-1 in the first league, and as you know very well, and Manchester City is a really great team, but in this country. Yeah, every game is not easy. Every game is not easy, and in this trophy, I think that Manchester City struggled a lot, no, to go to the next round, and for twice they went after the penalty, no, and it's the same for us against Norwich in FA Cup, and in this country, no easy game, and you must be prepared to fight in every game.
Okay, Bruce.
I mean, for all the criticism of your team not scoring a whole lot of goals recently, there were those 3-0s. You scored obviously last week against Norwich and at the weekend against Brighton, and your team are in good form. They haven't been beaten this calendar year, they've been beaten since before Christmas. So do you find it strange that some people have been criticising Chelsea for not scoring goals and maybe not being as entertaining as last year?
But if you look the stats, and for sure we scored less than last season. But at the same time, we conceded less. We are the best defenders, and the problem that I think in the last period we weren't very clinical. Because in every game we had the chances to score. Against Brighton, we scored four times. I think that we scored beautiful goals, and especially the second goal was an incredible goal. Now we have to try to continue in this way. And but as you know very well. Every game is different. Every game is different, and sometimes, if you are able to score early, and then the game becomes easy. If you struggle to score, and then improve the confidence of your opponent, and you become a bit nervous, and then everything becomes more difficult. Yeah.
Of course, tomorrow night, away goals may come into it at the end of extra time. So in that respect. Do you see yourselves as slight favourites? Because if you score, Arsenal have to go and win the game.
I must be honest. I think that we start 50% and 50%. And if we score, we have a little advantage. But at the same time, they have a big advantage to play at Emirates Stadium. Yeah, for this reason, I think that we start this game with the same probability to go to the to reach the final.
Finally, I know you get inundated with questions about the transfer window and who you're buying and who you're not buying. Does it affect the players? Does it affect you? Would you rather that we didn't have these transfer windows? Is it more of a pain in England than in Italy?
But. No, I think that there is this this window, and this window, for sure in 31 days is not simple, no? It's not simple to face with this situation, especially because in every team there are players that feel that they could change team. And it's not simple to work in this period, but at the same time, I have to praise my players because they show me every day great professionality, and I'm happy for this. For this reason, when I speak about my players, I can tell that in every case, I will be happy, and to continue with work with this group of players, or if there is some changes. Yeah, we must be ready. But in any case, I'm very happy.
You'll be glad when it's next Thursday, though, when it's closed and finished.
Yeah, I think it will be better not only for Chelsea but for every team.
Martin.
Hi, Antonio. Hi. I've been at all the games recently between the two clubs, and you say it's 50-50. What can your team do better to make it more chance of Chelsea? What are you looking at from your team to say, well, we know all about Arsenal, if we do this a bit better, we'll win?
Yeah, when you play against Arsenal, for sure you must be prepared to suffer without the ball. Because they like to be offensive, they like to bring many players in the box to try to find combinations between the strikers, the winger, the midfielders, and for this reason we must pay great attention. It will be important to be compact without the ball, but at the same time Arsenal know very well that when we have the ball we are dangerous in the same way like him. I think that we must pay great attention without the ball.
Is it a problem that there's a game tonight for your young players? Are you picking the team for this evening as well as the team Some players might want to be in the under 21 team that you might need tomorrow night.
No. I think that I have all my players available, and we are in the position that we have the possibility to reach the final, and in this case I think that the players that they are in the squad, it's right to have the possibility to play and to reach the final in this competition.
Yes,
Antonio, you've won 5 league titles in your career, but you've never won a cup competition. Does this have a special meaning for you personally to go and take a cup competition for yourself?
No, but as you know very well, it's not important for myself. And as I said before, for me, this could be a fantastic opportunity to play. To play for every competition and to reach the final in every competition in this country. And despite my experience, is only 1 year and a half. And after 10 plays, and in the first season to win the league, to reach the final FA Cup, in this season to play the Community Shield, and then to have the possibility to play another final in another competition here, I think this could be a fantastic opportunity for me in few time. And I think that for me and for my players, it will be great to reach this target. But we know very well that to reach this target, we have to be ready to fight against Arsenal, a massive game, a big challenge for us. But my target, the target of my players must be always to give 120% in every game, in every competition. And this must be our target. Then, as you know very well, there is only one team to win. But if you are able to fight during the season for every trophy and to try to give the satisfaction to your fans, I think that this is the must target that we have to reach.
Leo.
Antonio, clearly missing Morata and Fabregas is a big blow, but given the way that the front three played against Brighton, given how well they played, do you feel that you can now build on that and go and play the same way against Arsenal going forward?
No, I don't know. I have another night before to decide the start 11. Yeah. I think that every game is different. Every game is different. The opponent change the quality of your opponent, and you must be intelligent to understand if it's right to continue in this way with the same players or to make some changes. Yeah, I think that every game is different.
Yes, on the end.
Antonio, you mentioned you played Arsenal a lot recently, a lot of games against them, big games. Do you enjoy the personal challenge up against someone like Arsene Wenger, by far the most experienced manager in the league now? From a personal point of view, do you enjoy that challenge?
But we have to enjoy every big challenge in this league. And as you know very well, in this league, you have the possibility to play big games with a strong team, and it's right to enjoy. In this case, in this season, we are playing a lot of times against Arsenal, and but in this case, it means that both teams reached the semifinals, and because the other teams were eliminated, and now in this competition there are three top teams. And Manchester City and Chelsea and Arsenal, And then another team that that is very difficult to play against them.
Yes, sir.
Buongiorno Antonio, a couple of questions, please. Last year you played a fantastic game against Arsenal in the Premier League, but you just beat them one time. You have been a great player. Do you think it can affect player mind? Do you have to work with player mind about this? And second, I would like to ask you, yesterday Andrea Pirlo, that was your player, said that Italian football needs to be refounded. Do you think the same?
I think last season we saw two different games. The first game was a disaster for us because we lost 3-0 after 30 minutes. Yeah, and then after that game, I think that we changed a lot of things for us. And then in the second game at home, we won 3-1 because Giroud scored 92 minutes. Otherwise, we finished 3-0 in the same way like the first game. In this season, the first game in the league ended 0-0, 2-2 in the second leg. And I think that we are showing to be the same quality, no? Two teams with the same value, because when you play a lot of time and the final result is always in balance, it means that the value of these two teams are very, very close. But tomorrow, and there is not another game then, and we don't have another possibility. We have to try to reach the final, and in the same way we'll do Arsenal. What Pirlo said, as you know very well, I love this player, and now he's a former player, and unfortunately, I don't know. As you know very well, and what happened in Italy, it was a disaster to fail the World Cup. It was a disaster. For sure, we have to change something and to try to rebuild something important for the future, because I think Italy is a big country. And in Italy, football is the life for everyone. And I think that we have to change something for the future, because it's not right to stay out of the World Cup.
With Tomasi, do you think he can be the name?
No, I don't want to go into this this situation, and it's not important the name, it's important the fact, because now is a politic, and everyone try to do politic, to do I'll do this then, and it's it will be important to do fact, and I think that this will be the most important thing for the country, for the people, for Italian people.
Grazie.
Antonio, talking about the World Cup, yesterday FIFA announced they're going to use the video assistant referee in the World Cup, next World Cup in Russia 2018. What's your view on that? Do you think this will improve the game?
Could you repeat, please?
FIFA yesterday announced they will use the video.
VAR. Okay.
So, what's your view on that?
No, but... I'm positive. I think this new system can help us a lot the referees. I'm very positive because I think that it's right to win the team that deserves to win, and as you know very well, the referee's mistake during the game is Can be a referee mistake, and I think this could become a big mistake and to change the final result. In this way, I think that you can help the referee to make the best decision, and also to to cut the big responsibility to the referee.
Okay, great. Thanks. Cameras off then, people. Thank you. We'll move to